the last class we have worked out the theory on how Schrödinger equation can apply to the spherically symmetric potential. By spherically symmetric potential, we mean that it reduces to the fact that the potential of the radial distance r per is expressed in r theta phi coordinate system, so the p is also having angular dependence, and in that case h, L square and Lz, they can have the simultaneous eigen function, because h commutes with L square and h commutes with Lz too. So the simultaneous eigen function of L square and Lz are already known. This is YLM, the spherical Huggins, with the eigen value. The eigen value of L square operator is L into L plus 1, H line square, and that of Lz is M H line square by M for given L. M ranges from minus L to plus L in steps of unity. And the the whole function like that, the time independent Schrödinger equation is this. When we using separation of variable technique, we write R of R and YLM of YLM of theta phi. And it is found that R function depends on energy as well as on L. So it is REL. Furthermore, we put a reduced variable that REL of R is equal to UEL of R by R, so that with the requirement that UEL at 0 has to be 0. So at the origin it is 0 by 0 form, so REL is finite at R is equal to 0. And the resulting differential equation in terms of E comes up to found out to be H line square by twice L V2 L VR2 plus V effective of R UEL of R is equal to by V effective, we have defined as V of R plus L into L plus 1 H line squared by 1 to M R squared. This was defined as the centrifugal gradient potential. This was done in the earlier class. Today we shall apply this equation spherically symmetric potential, and we remark that this theory is valid so long as P of UR is finite always. And the behavior of UL near the origin is equal to the behavior of UL near the origin is R to the power L. So when it is written in terms of REL is up to the power L. The general solution of this differential equation for constant potential when the V happens to be a constant is found in terms of spherical Bessel function. For V is equal to constant, the solution is obtained K is equal to, this is the definition of K twice N E upon H line square. Since the Bessel function, spherical Bessel function is in our syllabus we restrict ourselves to the case A is equal to 0 case. A is equal to 0 case, so we get A squared case.
So the general equation is the equation is minus hi squared by 2iz can be written as d2 u e dr2 plus a squared u of e is equal to 0 plus a squared is equal to twice m upon h line squared, and to this greater than 0, so a is a real constant. So e of e as solution A sine kr plus b cos kr. Now you note that the condition is that e at 0 has to be 0, which indicates that b is to be 0. So is equal to a sine kr. So coming to the r of 0 is equal to u of e 0 by r, so this is a sine kr by r. The total work function is psi e of r theta phi is equal to, here we are using r zero of r times y here, since l 0 m is equal to 0, y 0 0 is 1 upon root 4 pi. So this is indeed a spherical wave, because if we calculate the probability current, the probability current density on the surface of a sphere, we find that we have 1 by r square dependent, and when we incident over a surface of a sphere of radius r, the total force is independent of r, which is the symmetry, which is nothing but the free particle. Now, Having been solved this equation, we come to the S-wave case for a particle within an infinite spherical well. This is our second example. That is, we define P of R is equal to 0 for R less than capital R, and it shoots to infinity for R greater than. So we know that in this case, the function in this region, the function has to be 0. So the boundary condition is R is real at capital R is equal to 0. So this is E at R by R is equal to 0. Now coming to this differential equation. Within the well, this differential equation is minus H lambda square by 2 I this part is 0, so it is equal to E to E, which gives you to E. Plus K square E equal to 0, but K square has a similar definition. A physically acceptable solution is sign of k. Now the cos kr part will be 0 because of the requirement that E at r is equal to 0 has to be finite. Now the boundary condition, this means that sin kr is equal to 0 is equal to sin of n part. So k is now quantized and it is given by by R. Correspondingly, the energy is not quantized. Energy is H line square Kn square upon 2R, which comes out to be pi square H line square divides N R square N square, the quantized energy values. Now the total wave function is written as, since it has theta phi independent case as A is equal to 0, we have changed. This is A upon 4 phi times sine of K N R by R, and this independence, this continuous subscript is now replaced by this. So we write it as psi n. And the normalization, if we normalize this, the angular, the normalization condition is as psi n modulus square r square dr d omega. When this wave function doesn't have any omega angular dependence, so that when we integrate d omega leads to 4 pi, which cancels with this, and the equation is left with this a modulus square, this r square will cancel with this. So we will have sin square a n r dr from 0 to capital R, which is so a is equal to 2 by r. So the normalized wave function becomes example of this sort is the hard sphere. First, hard sphere, you let me write this function. Hard sphere potential. This is just the reverse of this. No, the potential within a sphere is infinite and it is zero for R product. So what we will have? We will outside the sphere, hard sphere, here it will be outside hard sphere. This is our function. And here the second term will survive. The second term will survive. The boundary condition is that since the potential is infinite within the sphere, no particle can penetrate within the bulb. So this is the hard sphere. Particle cannot penetrate within it. No, it's not allowed. So the condition is that wave function has to be zero on the surface. So the boundary condition is U of R is equal to capital R is equal to zero. That gives you A sine AR plus B cos KR, which gives you the relation between A and B. And A R is equal to minus B by A. This much information we get, and depending on the energy, this B by we can get the coefficient, the fraction of the incident energy, the incident wave that is refracted from the hard sphere. This part we can get from here. Now we go to the second example. Finite sphere. This is instead of dealing with infinite world, we are dealing with the finite world. Finite spherical world, the potential is we define, this is the interior, internal region, this is external region. In the internal region, for R less than capital R, we have D2 in R, D R 2 plus k square ui is equal to 0, where k square is equal to twice n by h line square, and this gives you to ui is equal to r is equal to a sine kr, because r is equal to 0 falls in this region and cos part is 0 which you obtain from the continuum finite from the fact that ui is 0 at the origin, as ui of 0 is 0. For r greater than capital R with e less than g0, the distribution sort, this equation becomes 2 in external vr2 minus rho square in E is equal to 0, where rho square is equal to twice m b0 minus e up to h lambda square. Since b0 is greater than e, this is and e at r will be b to the power minus rho r plus c to the power plus rho r. difference from capital R to infinity and at infinity this term diverges. So the this is the solution in the external region. This is the solution in the internal region. This is the solution in the external region. The continuity of the wave function, since we are dealing with space wave case, we need to bother about the angular part. So we have R I at R is equal to R at R. Note that R I is equal to EI by R and R E is equal to E by R. So this simply comes for a simple term between sine K R is equal to E to the power minus 1. Now the second condition is that dri dr at capital R is equal to dr at capital R. So this is dr of ui by R. Constant will differentiate the E part is common. We first keep this part constant and this is K cos K R by R and this is minus sine K R by R square. First differentiate the denominator, so it gives you minus 1 by r square and then put the limit. This the numerator function has been differentiated and then note that one r square is common to this two term, so these two term cancels out to this relation. So these two term cancels each other. So we will have and this r gets cancelled. So ak cos kr, this is one equation, and this is equation one. Equation two is ak cos kr is equal to minus b rho e to the power minus rho r. This is equation 2. So if we divide this, we get cot kr minus rho by k. This is the equation. Similar equation we obtain in the case of finite rectangular potential well. So we divide this as cot e is equal to minus q and the upper term is m square minus u square by 2, where e is defined as kr and define vitalize in IH line square, and Un is defined as twice in IH line. So we know how to get the solution of this equation. This is the KR axis and this is KR. What function is that? This is that. This is known to you from the study of finite rectangular potential well. And the right hand side, as u tends to 0, it goes to minus infinity, and it goes to 0 minus at u is equal to u m. So this is the u m line, the graph. The graph is of this shape. This is the right hand side graph. And so it is the first energy state, this is the second exit state, this is down state, this is the first excited state. You know, that um, if this point, this is the pi by u, if um is less than pi by u, there is no bound state. If um is greater than pi by u and less than 3 pi by u, there is only one bound state. The second bound state is obtained for um is greater than 3 pi by 2. So this is just the odd part of a symmetric finite potential well. We have dealt with the delta function in Cartesian coordinates. Here we shall use the spherically symmetric delta function potential. That is to say, we have a origin, and this is the sphere of spherical cell of radius a, and the situation is such that only on the spherical shell the particle experiences a force, and it is a free particle when it is not on the surface of the world. Such a potential is known as delta shell potential. It is given by V of R to Unit Man. Simply by mathematics, it is generally written as where the potential is attractive is lambda is zero. A lambda is heavy and it is repulsive for lambda, positive value from lambda, as we have found it in other cases. Now let me write the Schrödinger equation. Schrödinger equation for this in terms of reduced parameter, it is h line square by 2 is plus for potential it is h line square lambda by twice m delta of r minus a plus the centrifugal part. We confine ourselves to this vector. For r not equal to a, this is simply prepared. And around r is equal to a, we just integrate this thing. Limit epsilon tends to 0, integration over dr from a minus epsilon to a plus epsilon. variable, this part will cancel, so cos theta, I integrate it. So we get u prime of e from this part, I get a plus, and from this part, we get u prime e at a minus, and from this part, we will get. So there is a minus sign, but it will be taken on the other side. It is lambda e and this is the relation involving the discontinuity of the first derivative of the wave function. Now we consider the scattering case. Or scattering case. Is greater than 0. So this part, this equation comes out with u. u of r, there are two variables. One is within the well, another one is outside the well. Within the well is a sin kr, because in this region, the origin lies, and on the other side it is b sin kr plus c cos kr for r rather than equal to that. What is coming to the first here the equal to sign value came because the function is continuous, but here there is no equal to sign as the first derivative of the function is not continuous as per the solution. Now if we use these two on the here, we get two relations involving A, B and C in terms of K and capital R, which can be solved to give B by A and C by A, where from we can calculate the probability current density. Since the calculation is involved, we are high from the equations. If we look for the bound state case, for bound state, capital R, and it is equal to C to rho will count minus a to the power minus rho r plus b to the power plus rho r for r less than capital R. And this is minus c to the power minus rho r for r parameter. Again, we can apply, use these two relations. We can get a relation of B by A and C by A in terms of K and K, rho and capital R, which may be solved in the derivative of bound state problem. His left hand home has a home of the complete calculation. By this problem, we have solved the simple problem, simple examples where the square potential is spherically symmetric, and to keep us away from spherical Bessel function, we have considered only the a square case. If we include L not equal to 0 cases, then the calculation will be which involved mathematically and which is not taken up there. By this example, we end our discussion on a simple application. From the next class onwards, we shall consider the two-body interacting system where the potential is a Coulomb potential, that is a spherical symmetric potential, and we will discuss in detail about the wave function of an electron revolving around the nucleus in hydrogenic atom.